special person.
Hey, okay, everybody. Rehearsal in 10 minutes. Stand by for the big production number. Come on.
Would you explain that to us again?
Yeah, what is this?
Well, see, it's a tribute. That's all Kermit said in his note here. Can you read?
Okay,
it says, don't forget to do the big production number for the tribute, 8:45 p.m. Wednesday. That's tonight. That's tonight!
Well, who's the tribute for?
You forgot to say.
Perhaps it is a tribute to my beloved first boomerang fish, Connie Sue.
Connie Sue?
She was the first fish I could throw out into the air. And then they come back to me.
Guys, mail call. Boy, it's a postcard from Kermit.
Oh, a postcard from my Uncle Kermit. What's it say?
It says, dear gang, I hope all is well with you. I'm fine, and we'll be back with you soon.
I always miss him when he goes off traveling.
Yeah. More.
I forgot to tell you that the big production number is meant to be a tribute to Jim Henson.
Jim Henson. Yes. Who's Jim Henson?
Well, I don't know.
Do you know Jim Henson?
I don't know. Kermit goes on. I knew you guys would be confused. Watch the monitor, and it will all come clear.
Hey, show's
start. Welcome to the Muppets Celebrate Jim Henson, with special appearances by Harry Belafonte, Carol Burnett, Ray Charles, John Denver, and Steven Spielberg. A tribute to a man and his imagination.
Hey, that must be him.
Yeah, Jim Henson. Hey! I remember this Jim Henson fella.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he was always hanging around.
Where?
Down there.
Down there?
What do you mean?
Whoa. Hey, who are those guys?
I don't know, but they're still following us around.
Wow. Hey, look. When we move, they move. Try it.
Okay, move. This is good.
Stop.
You know? Let's stop looking at him even. It's too weird.
Yeah, but Robin's right. That's where we used to see Jim Henson.
And you know what else I remember most about him?
What?
Well, he was always watching us and having a great time.
Yeah. Hey, look.
There's Fozzie. There you are.
And the lights are bright and they're playing our old song.
When you're around.
When you're around.
Down to town.
Down.
Fairy
blues can't get into our shoes because our shoes refuse to ever go weary. We keep tearful on and earful of music sweet because we've got happy.
Why does the chicken cross the road? Why does the chicken cross the road?
It's the Muppet Baby.
Easy, wasn't it? And there's Piggy dancing in the movie.
Yeah.
Right. Great movie paper.
Dear sweetheart, it's not like that. It's like this.
Manamana. Manamana.
Je rêve, c'est pas que comme ça. Est-ce que je veux
15 love.
Stuff.
Yeah.
And Jim Henson was responsible for all that?
Well, we were in some of those clips.
You mean Jim Henson was responsible for us?
Well, a tribute to a fella like that would have to have style and wit and charm and eloquence.
You're right. You fill the water balloons and I'll get the whoopee cushions.
When you show up to work with the Muppets, it's a very special experience.
Hey, look, it's Carol Burnett.
It was a kind of place I felt comfortable bringing my daughter. I remember watching Jim introduce her to the performers and show her how to make puppets.
Make what?
Shh.
Backstage, it was like a family. Maybe that's why on stage, the Muppet characters are like a family too. They have love and sibling rivalry, good times and bad. And they provide each other.
What's she talking about?
She says we're like a family.
No, we're not.
Yes, we are.
No, we are not.
Yes, we are.
We are not like a family.
Yes, we are like a family.
Listen to me. I'm telling you.
Will you guys cut it out?
Oh, sorry.
Sorry, Carol.
Where was I? Oh, yes. Like any family we would want to be a part of, the Muppets find each other endlessly exasperating and helplessly forgiving.
Jesus, but, you know, I was born in this swamp. My roots are there, and I just wanted you and my other friends to see it. But we don't have to go back to the swamp. We can go to back where you were born. The sty. You know, where your roots are. Where pigs eat swill and wallow in the mud. Remember that? Huh? Huh?
Remember this?
I gotcha.
Gotcha.
No. I got red gum. I got.
No. Fozzie, hold on a second. Let me make one little change. Right? Okay, I'll sing it.
Yes, sir. I don't got rhythm. I don't got rhythm.
Anyone can fly as long as he believes that he can. Stand at the very top of a tall ladder and say to yourself, I was born to fly.
I was born to fly.
The air is my home.
The air is my home.
Now that you believe that, step off the ladder and float to the ceiling.
Why don't you tell our audience, how long have you been playing the drums? One, two. Piggy?
Yes, my chérie.
Piggy, have you been planting items about us in the gossip papers again?
What would make you think a thing like that?
A photographer who was just here. He was from Tongue Magazine.
What was this? Tiny item.
It was a cover story about us being secretly married.
What a slight exaggeration.
That's a bald-faced lie, Piggy.
I will not
stand around while you do dumb things like that, Piggy. You
dumb.
Have done that to me too many times, Piggy. I will not stand for it.
What are you
going to
do?
I'll tell you what I'm going to do, Piggy. I'm going to fire you. Piggy, you are fired. You are fired, Piggy. You are fired. Fired.
Guest stars had the honor of being a part of this family, whether they liked it or not.
Damn it, I am not going to do some cloth-eared Mexican maracas solo.
It doesn't have to be a solo, guys.
That does not help.
Oh, no? Well, how about this? Hi, everybody.
Come on. There is no way I'll do a song.
There is no way he'll do a song.
We'll stop this at once.
We will stop this at once.
This is not funny.
Oh, we hope this is funny.
Right. I'm leaving.
Hey, now, Carol, I realized that first number was a little shaky.
Shaky? Shaky? You call that number shaky? Oh, sorry.
Everyone promised me a variety show. Where's all the songs? Where are all the dances?
Where's your partner?
They played, they argued, they bickered, but through it all, they faced the world together.
Mr. Price, I'm Kermit, yeah. And these are my friends, and we've got a show called Manhattan Melodies that we think you're going to want to produce on Broadway.
Yeah.
Well, it's all about life in the big city.
Mm-hmm. Big city. Mm-hmm. You be the stars. Mm-hmm. Unknowns. Mm-hmm. Songs. Dances. Mm-hmm. Shootings.
Mm-hmm.
gotta be crazy chasing me halfway across the country. Why are you doing this to me?
Because all my life I wanted to own 1,000 frog leg restaurants, and you're the key, Greeny.
Yeah, well, I've got a dream, too. But it's about singing and dancing and making people happy. That's the kind of dream that gets better the more people you share it with. And, well, I found a whole bunch of friends who have the same dream. And it kind of makes us like a family.
Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me.
Like a movie, write your own ending.
Keep believing, keep pretending. We've done just what we set out to do.
Okay, good, Bo. Our costumes, check that
off the list.
All right,
look out, make way, make
way. Oh, Gonzo, come on now.
We
have to do this number in about a half an hour, and it has to work.
Of course it'll work. I've just arranged for the whoopee cushions, and they'll be here in a few minutes.
Oh, great. That's... The trouble is, we just don't know enough about this Jim Henson fellow yet to do a really good job.
Yo, Fozzie, this is your lucky day. Look what I found.
Oh, hi, Clifford. Well, what's the role of film?
Well, Jim Henson's biography.
Great!
Yeah, it was lying on Kermit's desk.
Oh, great!
Yeah. Yo, yo! You got the projector-threaded bunny man?
Did you call me a yo-yo?
Roll film.
Hello, everyone. I'm Bean Bunny, your projectionist for the evening. Refreshments are available.
Oh, just roll film. Okay,
get down. Down in front.
James Maury Henson was born in Greenville, Mississippi.
Ooh, like he's a little kid. How adorable.
Even as a child, he knew he wanted to work in television. In college, he began performing at a local TV station in Washington, D.C. Soon, he and his wife, Jane, were doing Sam and Friends, a late-night puppet show.
Puppet show?
Forget it.
What can I do? I hear your name and I'm afraid.
His puppets were unlike any the world had ever seen. They lived in a world made by the television frame. There, he discovered puppets could be bigger and more real than they had ever seemed before.
It's Kermit. He's lying on it.
What's he
pulling?
Hello there. My name is Jim Henson, and I'm a puppeteer. And I'm called a puppeteer because I work with puppets. And my own act, my puppet act, is called The Muppets.
He made us laugh not just with jokes, but with ideas.
And then I got interested in jazz.
Oh, I don't like jazz.
Jazz has a very different look to it. It moves, see? Like this. Oh, cool, you pop it up, 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 up.
Gee, I see.
Yeah, and here's where it can get dangerous.
Why? That doesn't seem very dangerous to me.
Well, jazz tends to linger, and you can't get away from it. So you go this way, or you go this way, and it stays right with you.
Ah, it bugs you then?
Not bad.
Okay, buddy, what do you think of Wilkins coffee?
I never tasted it.
Now, what do you think of Wilkins?
His characters had personality, because inside was the hand of Jim Henson. Jim's imagination roamed beyond the world of puppets. This is his experimental film, Timepiece, which was nominated for an Oscar in 1965.
show's over. Oh, hey.
You ruined Jim Henson's biography.
Hey, look, there's John Denver.
Maybe he knows about Jim Henson.
In 1969, a group called the Children's Television Workshop found something so intriguing about Jim's work, they asked him to create new Muppet characters for an experimental children's program. They had a notion that Jim's characters could use their unusual combination of sincerity and humorous irreverence to convey real information.
Say, the show did you know that John Denver's real name is Henry John Deutschendorf Jr.?
What are you doing?
Oh, well, I'm just using my sincerity and humorous irreverence to convey real information.
Right. Thanks.
You're welcome.
The show they created changed everything. For kids, for parents, and for TV.
What are we going to do for a title? Open up new worlds. Hey, Ralph? Why don't you call your show Sesame Street? My entire career as a TV educator nipped in the... What was that? Sesame Street. You know, like Open Sesame? It kind of gives the idea of a street where neat stuff happens. Kermit, why, you're a genius! Mwah!
I'm the cool dude in town, but it's getting me down. They just can't leave me alone, man. Wherever I go, all the other kids go. They even copy my clothes, man. Sometimes I need a break, so I say, peace, kids, please. I need to get away, just my fridge and me. Or a snack that's thick and fruity and good to eat. Cause I like a ski man.
I like ski man. Oh, I like ski. Oh, I like ski man.
I like ski, cause it's a thick and fruity.
Oh, I like a ski man.
I do like a ski man.
Orangina, capture the refreshing taste.
Orangina.
Full of life, your Whiskers kitten. He loves his Whiskers kitten food. Full of kindness, your Whiskers cat. She deserves her Whiskers. Young or old, cats instinctively know what they like and what's good for them. Cats would buy Whiskers.
The Muppets swooped up children and us along with them, like playmates in a game of discovery. From then on, we followed Jim wherever he led us because, like every great teacher, he made us feel we had learned these lessons all by ourselves.
H-I-J-K-L-M-N-O-P Q-R-S Cookie Monster. Cookie Monster isn't the letter of the alphabet. It goes Q-R-S-T-U-V. You're just teasing me. W-X-Y-N-Z. Now I know my ABCs.
Next time, Cookie Monster.
Next time, Cookie Monster can do it with you. I'm leaving.
I love you.
I love you too.
Thanks.
Around, 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 over, and under, and through. That's what I'm teaching.
C is for cookie. That's good enough for me. Oh, cookie, cookie, cookie starts with C. Yeah.
I don't want to play a game with rhymes.
Nice going, Bert. Oh, ring my chime.
I don't want to do it.
There's really nothing to it.
It's so silly.
A boy named Billy.
Stop it, please.
A dog has fleas.
Ow.
No.
Quietly rests the sleepy tiger under the vine tree at the waterside, and X marks the place neath the yellow moon where the Zulu chief and I did hide.
Let's get right to it, if we can, Kermit.
Yes.
Talk to me about, we constantly refer to the market as though we all knew what the market was.
Right.
You do.
Well, if you wanted to know the definition of the term market, or stock market as we say, it's basically, it's very simple. It's just where the brokers buy and sell stocks on behalf of other people. It's just like a fruit market or any other kind of market.
Excuse me. Kermit, when are you coming home?
When the show's over.
Well, you said the show was just a little bit of time.
Yes, well, you know, we're busy. We're teaching everything.
Oh,
did you learn all our terms?
Yes, Ted. Hello, Ted. Mm.
Good evening, Miss Piggy. It's a delight
dear.
To have you with us. I didn't know you were going to join us
tonight. Well, I've been watching out there waiting for Kermit.
There was a time when life was grand.
Listen to how Jim used this small frog to teach the plight of the rainforest.
As the world rolls along, more and more I see. There just isn't any more for me.
Sometimes the most important lessons Jim's characters taught us were lessons of the heart.
It's in every one of us, by and by.
How's our production number in honor of Jim Henson going?
Well, it's getting better.
Great.
A little bit better.
Huh?
Oh, it's not getting worse.
Huh?
I hired a Dixieland band. Hey, guys. Huh? Yeah. All right, so maybe it's getting worse.
Hi, everyone. I'm here.
Hey, Whoopi! Wow, it's great to see you! Look, everybody, it's Whoopi Cushions, the tap dancer!
Yeah!
All right, cut! Thank you!
Honey!
Oh, meet my wife! This is Joy!
Hi, how are you?
Well, nice to meet you, Joy.
Her maiden name was Buzzer!
I guessed that!
Oh, look, honey, it's Ray Charles!
Oh, I'm Ray Charles. What makes an artist truly unique is that he can take the most ordinary things in life and turn them into something extraordinary. Now, Jim Henson took a simple song and a piece of felt and turned it into a moment of great power. You know, the song says, it's not easy being green, but the song is about knowing who you are. And in it, you can hear Jim's message loud and clear. We should learn to love who we are and be proud of it. And that's the way we learn to love each other.
But green's the color of spring, and green can be cool and friendly like. And green can be big like a mountain, or important like a river, or tall like a tree.
It's not that easy to breathe. It seems you blend in with so many other ordinary things, and people tend to pass you over, but you're not standing out like flashy sparkles on the water or stars in the sky. Well, you're falling like a mountain.
You got so far for the production number, huh?
Oh, about Scooter, I've been thinking. Maybe we should make this a biking number, huh?
A what?
A biking number.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what it needs. Lots of bicycles. Oh, boy, it sure needs something.
And we know just what that is.
She's the one and only beautiful girl. The one and only beautiful girl.
About.
It's a grand entrance for my tribute to Jim Henson.
Well, don't you think it's just a little over the top?
Yes! Isn't it wonderful?
Miss Piggy, do you know anything about Jim Henson?
Nope. Not particularly. Anybody here know?
Hey, maybe Steven Spielberg knows.
Jim Henson was a master storyteller whose most popular appeal focused on the adventures of a frog and his friends. But there were other kinds of stories he also told. Fantastic stories, for which he invented entire worlds and enormously complex creatures. The faster Jim's imagination ran, the more delight he took in finding a technology to achieve this. He used tools of the special effects trade and then went outside the film world to find technology that hadn't ever been used before and even tried that out. With craftsmen at his creature shop in London, he developed fantastic creatures that were operated by cables, electronic rods, computers, and all sorts of radio controls. But the human drama was always there, laying at the heart of the story and creating the reason for his imaginary worlds to exist.
To the health of that most beautiful woman who could not keep her promise for one more day.
Husband.
How did you find me?
I have walked the world to find you. I have worn out the soles of 3 pairs of iron shoes. My hair is no longer red. But I come to claim you, and catch you up, and snoodle you and hug you to bits.
As you like. You're not dreaming now. Look! Chansey didn't create me. You did.
How?
In your dreams, you've got the talent. It's a gift.
No!
Oops. Sorry. What do you say? Don't you want to be rich? Famous?
No!
Coward!
We have a visitor. A guest. And he's whistling.
That's a nice whistle. I want to have it.
Hello.
I hear you like a game of cards.
Oh, you like a game of cards. Sure.
Let's play then.
Many of his stories were based on European folk tales or Greek myths, but some others came from Jim's own restless imagination.
My friend the soldier. He's somewhere about his business.
You sure?
Come on. You can have your biscuit.
With every new day a new chance.
Excuse me, everybody. Only a few minutes to go. Stand by for rehearsal.
Okay, Beauregard. Push it in.
Okay. What's this?
Boat.
What boat?
The Viking boat. You said you wanted a Viking number.
I said a Viking number. You know, bikes, bicycles, as in Schwinn?
We don't have a Schwinn. We got a Sven.
Yeah, but you open your mini. I've been Schwinn. You bet.
Hurdy-murdy. Hurdy-murdy. Hurdy-murdy.
Excuse me. Please don't watch us. It's too embarrassing. Watch Harry Belafonte instead, okay?
There's no question about Jim Henson's great artistry and the extent to which we've all been touched by it. Whether the audience was American or European, Japanese or Indian or African, Jim's characters reached them, taught them, and entertained them. But greater than Jim's artistry was his humanity. Unless you have moved among the peoples of this earth who have so little hope for the future of their lives, you will never really understand how Jim Henson has made a difference for them. Those desperate places where parents watch their children grow, knowing they'll never be educated, will never have a chance at life as it should be. These same parents watch as Jim's creations for the first time not only put smiles on the faces of their children, but develop in them the appetite to learn watching Sesame Street and the ability to love because they see the love and the caring that exudes from the Muppets and the Henson family of creatures. This was the Jim Henson I knew. The Muppet Show became the most popular show in the history of television all over the world.
It's time to get things started on the most sensational, inspirational, celebrational, Muppetational.
It is one of the first American television shows to be seen in Russia.
Okay, спасибо, спасибо. И добро пожаловать на Muppet Show.
Sesame Street is seen in 121 countries, from Spain to Senegal to Cincinnati.
We are the children of tomorrow.
He even created a series called Fraggle Rock, designed specifically for people everywhere, in which characters of different sizes and shapes had to learn how to live together.
A brother, one in heart, one in hope, one in name.
All right now, everybody!
We are the children of tomorrow.
Wonderful!
Each one is different and the same.
What Jim knew was that there really isn't any difference between us. And if we can take the time to understand each other, together, we can turn the world around.
We come from the water, living in the water. Go back to the water, turn the world around.
We come from the mountain, living on the mountain. Go back to the mountain, turn the world around.
Do you know who I am? Do I know who you are? See, we one another clearly. Do we know
see we want to have a clearly. Do we know who we are?
Do you know who I am?
Another
cute little Afro Norwegian number.
Hey, Gonzo!
What?
Gonzo! Where's Fozzie?
Oh, he's in makeup for the big production number.
Listen, I have discovered who this Jim Henson fellow really was.
No!
Yes, I was back in the office and I found one of your old paychecks.
Oh, I always forget to cash those things. We artists and madmen are like that.
Yeah, well, just look who signed it.
Jim Henson! But that must mean he was...
an accountant.
No!
Yes, so here's our tribute number. The Merrill Lunch Hunga Dunga McCormick All Accountant Marching Society.
3,014,1,897 times the current prime rate standing at 11. Surtax, sales tax, excise due. Net worth Dow Jones.
Watch out for the...
I'm Frank Oz. I worked with Jim for 27 years, playing characters like Bert, Fozzie, Miss Piggy. During that time, I watched a man who truly believed nothing was impossible. He envisioned a world where chickens could sing, bears could tell jokes, pigs could be stars, and they could all ride bicycles.
Just a bush and we're on the way. Yes, couldn't we ride?
In the center of this was Jim, and he loved every minute of it.
My ancestor, the Viking, was terrible at plundering and pillaging.
He was?
Yes, he plundered his plundering and he blundered.
Well, yes, here we are.
There was the same kind of mayhem behind the scenes as there was in front of it.
Hey, we gotta get organized around here. Will somebody tell those fans to knock it off?
Knock it off!
Knock it off! Knock it off!
Now, will we knock off the knocking it offs?
Knock off the knocking it off!
Knock off the knocking it off!
Knock off
knock
the knocking
it
off!
Jim had a way of keeping a gentle rein on us lunatics. He did it mostly by just standing back and appreciating. He appreciated the best each of us had to give. He encouraged us, he nurtured us, and he provided us with a great example. His characters could be silly and warm and wise and funny and strong, just like Jim. You'll find a little part of him in each one of them. Some of my favorite times with my friend were when I played Bert and he played Ernie. It was a magical relationship.
Oh, Bert. Thank you so much for stopping me from eating cookies in my bed.
All right, Ernie, just go to bed, okay?
Okay. And I'm never going to eat cookies in my bed again.
Okay, good. Ernie, what are you doing?
I'm going to eat cookies in your bed, Bert. Cheeky in the basket. Oh. And for spirit, the cheeky. Oh. And over here. The basket.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hey, Cheeky! Oh, come here, Cheeky!
He could be out and out goofy. He could sing weird songs.
I'm a greenback collector, I'm a paper bill inspector, I'm a savage for that cabbage man. To me is golden nectar. Pour that filthy lucre on me, spread those loving germs upon me. Money, 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 money.
And he performed a whole bunch of great, funny characters. Everything Jim did and everything Jim was a call to the best part of ourselves.
Cobblestone, cobblestone pie. A fish can't whistle and neither can I. Ask me a riddle and I reply. Cobblestone, cobblestone, cobblestone pie.
I will make a wish on a star.
and I'll wish I was home once again. Though I'd like to look down at the earth from above, I would miss all the places and people I love. So although I may go, I'll be coming home soon. 'Cause I don't want to live on the moon. No, I don't want to live on the moon.
I didn't promise anybody anything. What do I know about Hollywood anyway? Just the dreams I got from sitting through too many double features. So why did you leave the swamp in the first place? 'Cause some agent fella said I had talent. He probably says that to everybody.
On the other hand, if you hadn't left the swamp, you'd be feeling pretty miserable anyhow.
Yeah. But then it would just be me feeling miserable. Now I got a lady pig, and a bear, and a chicken, a dog, a thing, whatever Gonzo is. He's a little like a turkey.
Yeah, a little like a turkey, but not much.
No, I guess not. Anyhow, I brought them all out here into the middle of nowhere. It's all my fault.
Still, whether you promised them something or not, you gotta remember, they wanted to come.
But that's because they believed in me.
No,
they believed in the dream.
Well, so do I, but...
You do?
Yeah, of course I do.
Well then, I guess I was wrong when I said I never promised anyone. I promised me.
Okay, everybody, okay, gather around. It's finally time for the Jim Henson tribute production number.
Oh, boy, okay, all right,
Vikings,
okay.
Remember, come in on the second chorus.
Accountants.
Hey, don't tap dance until we fly in the giant 1040 form. And Scooter, Gonzo, come on, help me with this thing. Move it out of the way. Wait, ho. What's this? Never noticed this before. It says... For Fozzie, these might inspire some ideas for the tribute number. These are real letters. Oh, from Jim's fans. Oh, boy.
Read some.
Should I?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see. It says, Dear Kermit, my cousin Diane has a pet frog, and she named him Kermit. And he could say, hi, just like you.
Isn't that sweet?
Yeah. Really... I feel very sorry that your best friend Jim died. Jim died?
But we were just starting to get to know him.
Perhaps the substance of Jim Henson's genius was the ability to see wonder far off in crazy directions and get people to follow him there. Roberta Moran, Dover Plains, New York.
Dear Kermit, I hope you feel better. I will miss Jim Henson, too. I hope this letter makes you feel better. I love you. Bridget Kerwin, Peabody, Massachusetts.
You know, Mr. Henson was a very good, talented teacher. He will never be dead in my heart. Elizabeth Nicola Edelman, Mountain Lakes, New Jersey.
While falling asleep that night, our 5-year-old daughter Blair said, "It's a good thing there are people who can do Jim Henson's job. He'll be with us every time we watch the Muppets. He'll be able to see them from heaven." The Reeser family, Las Vegas, Nevada.
We will miss you, Jim Henson. Matt.
Cancel.
What?
Cancel the production number. Cancel everything.
What about the tribute?
I did it all wrong. I mean, when you read these letters and when you know how much people loved him, we can't do a tribute to him.
Kermit thought we could.
Oh, but Robin, all we have is silly songs and whoopee cushions.
Maybe that's enough. Well, that's what Uncle Kermit says. Take what you got and fly with it.
Fly with it? Kermit says that?
I think he learned it from Jim. You know, this Jim Henson may be gone, but, well, maybe he's still here, too, inside us, believing in us.
If just one person believes in you, deep enough and strong enough believes in you, hard enough and long enough, before you knew it, someone else would think, if he can do it, I can do it. Making it to whole people who believe in you, deep enough and strong enough believe in you, hard enough and long enough, there's bound to be some other person who believes in making it a threesome, making it three people you can say believe in me. And if three whole people, why not four? And if four whole people, why not more and more and more? And when all those people believe in you, deep enough and strong enough believe in you, hard enough and long enough, it stands to reason you yourself would start to see what everybody sees in you.
Good song. I knew you guys could do the tribute for Jim.
Was it really okay?
It was terrific. You guys were great.
But
do you have something silly to end with?
Silly? Do we have something silly?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Cue the production number. Yeah.
Well, that just about brings us down to the end of another one, but before we go, let me thank you for being with us for our tribute to Jim Henson. And we'll be seeing you soon with more Muppet Stuff, because that's the way the boss would want it.
And don't forget that old magic Muppet Stuff is with you every weekday in Sesame Street at 1 o'clock.
This is Channel 4 with Paul McCartney's Liverpool Oratorio, introduced by the man himself.
I remember coming here to Liverpool Anglican Cathedral when I was 11 to audition for the choir. I failed the audition. I always hoped that one day I'd be able to get my own back. 3 years ago, I was given the opportunity when Carl Davis approached me on behalf of the Royal Liverpool Philharmonic Society to write a piece for their 150th anniversary celebrations. Carl and I started working then on what was to become the Oratorio for Liverpool. Finally, after hundreds of hours of scoring and rescoring, we finished it. So here I am 38 years later, returning to Liverpool Cathedral, still not having made it into the choir. But tonight, I'll be happy to be part of the audience.
And it's not given very often. It's over 20 years since anybody was given the freedom of the city. And there are only 5 living people who have the honour at the moment, and they include the Queen.
When I was first approached about it, I didn't really understand the historical significance of it. 1465, I think, to start. People from admirals and kings and queens and princes, names like David Livingstone, Ben Franklin, Ben Jonson. It's an amazing list. Looking through it all, I think I was the first from Fountain Bridge. To England, that was my first move away. And then in 74, when I moved out of England to go non-resident, that was my second move. But home is really where you're working, if you work as much as I do. My wife, she's very much for what I want to do, where I want to go. She's very supportive, and she really made this whole place here in Spain what it is.
We would prefer really to have only one place. We became resident in the Bahamas, so we bought a house in the Bahamas, which is a lovely house. We have an apartment in Los Angeles because we spend a lot of time in Los Angeles for Sean work. We are now resident in Monte Carlo. Mainly our house is here. I rebuilt the whole thing along the years with a mason and 3 men. I did the architecture myself. It was great fun for me. I decided for Christmas to give to Sean a happening, and I had exactly 3 months to do it. He was at the time doing The Untouchable in Chicago. So I brought him in here on the Christmas Eve, on the 24th. He was coming back from the plane, from the airport. And I brought him here. I said, I made a happening for you. And Jason, Stefan, Hassan Mohamed came here. And I had covered the door with the ribbon and the fan and the roses and so on. And I said, well, what do you think of it? And he said, oh, that's very beautiful. I said, okay, rip it down. He said, what do you mean? I said, yes, it's happening, you rip it down. So he came, torn it, and he saw Happy Christmas, Sean. And he said, oh, it's a door, you made another terrace, because before there was a little window. And I said, well, open it. So he opened it. And here was this dressing room and bathroom where he spent at least 2 hours a day. And he was like a little boy. Was really so happy.
Waited a long time for it, it has to be said.